A very good morning once again. TV. My name is Lynn Komjisha. I'm glad you're joining us this morning in time for The Big Issue. And you can go to our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda, on Twitter, Urban Television, on Facebook. We're also on Instagram and Snapchat and everywhere, every social media platform. Go to our YouTube channel as well, and you can find most of our programs there. Today we are looking at a very interesting developing story. I think it has stories within the story, so we are going to look at most of them within that particular story. So we've noticed that over 1,000 police posts have shut down, over 1,600 have shut down. Police recently, you saw the attacks, you've been seeing in the news that police posts around the country, not around the country, in some parts of the country were attacked. And some of them have, some police officers have lost their lives. Others have, sustained injuries. The recent one in Chanja, no one was injured, and no ammunition was, stolen from there. But recently, police is also reviewing its territorial policing, and we want to delve into those. Where does this leave us as the community in regard to security, in regard to what's happening? Why is police not telling us exactly what is going on? Why are these attacks happening? When did all this start? Joining me to discuss that and so much more is ACP Hilary Kulaije, Deputy Director, Chief Political Commissar, and also Charles Etukuri. Charles Etukuri is the multimedia journalist here at Vision Group. And he's really carried most of the security stories we see in the new vision. Gentlemen, I'm very glad to have you this morning. I want to begin with Charles. Charles, all those issues, in the past 2 to 3 weeks now, we've been having issues over security, police posts are being attacked. What is happening? Where did all this start from, and how are we here now?
Thank you for hosting us. The decision to merge the police stations, as we talked about, as you talked about shortly ago, was not something that started recently. So at the 25th Council, I think in 2019, the President directed that police should be brought back at the sub-county level. And the main purpose was to ensure there's more efficiency and coordination. So it should be attributed to the wave of the recent attacks. It's only that police started implementing it recently. Now, initially, of course, we had so many police posts across the country. And the issue was whoever came up with a building or whoever wanted police protection would be given police. The purpose was to try as much as possible to create a number of structures down there to curb criminality. But I think the process was abused largely because you saw whoever wanted, there were two police station people manning a station, and this exposed them.
Yes.
Some of them didn't have the technical capacity to handle crime or respond to issues. So bringing police back to the sub-county was supposed to create a sufficient team.
Are the attacks attributed to that move?
Not really. These are current wave of attacks should not be looked at, viewed at in the court. But the issue is police with expansion, when they went on an expansion mode, they were left exposed because you'd find two people, four people manning a station.
Yes.
So they became vulnerable to attacks.
That's true.
So it's only unfortunate that the implementation is being done now, but it's an old decision of 2019 where the president directed that police should be brought at the sub-county level.
Now, Hilary here, with the spate of attacks on police posts, have you arrived at a conclusion of what is happening? Or is it subject still under investigation and you cannot tell us?
Yeah, thank you so much. Let me first make just two corrections.
Mm.
One, I was elected and was promoted to the rank of a commissioner.
My apologies,
I'm now
sir.
A commissioner, not an assistant commissioner.
Okay.
Then, secondly, it's true some police posts are being merged, but they are not the figure you are quoting.
Oh.
We're talking about 1,600. No, they are actually 129 so far.
So far?
That have been merged.
But maybe 1,600 affected.
I find he's talking about so far.
We're
talking
so,
about
so far.
National.
Yeah, of course, let us talk about what has what has been implemented so far.
Okay.
So there are just 129.
Okay.
And Charles, thank you so much. Charles has made my work so easy.
Mm.
Exactly, that's how it was. It is not something that we are now in a panic mode and we are merging these posts because of these attacks.
But why did you wait this long?
No, it's true. President directed
2019.
Now COVID came in. Of course, when he directed, you needed to first study. How are you going to do it? So as we are planning to implement, COVID-19 came in.
Mm.
So it has been a coincidence that this attack came in as we are getting ready to implement the presidential directive.
Mm.
And what you, of course, you have said, the attacks, I may not go in too deep, but of course, intelligence and investigations already know the groups that are targeting these police.
Okay.
And some have been arrested, but I may not really go into the
absolutely
details.
Are they, according to what Charles has said, are they taking advantage of the vulnerabilities of these police posts? Previously, they were manned by, say, 2 to 3 people.
Of course, I cannot concentrate that it is just one group. There are quite many.
Ah.
Well, some, basically, to create fear within the public. Mm. That if they can attack the police, then what about the public? Then there are others that are targeting guns.
Mm-hmm.
They want to get these guns. Who knows? To use it for.
Right.
So it is not just one group, according to intelligence.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, beg your pardon. With this merger of Charles, if I could engage you, with this merger, we are seeing that there, it's a pilot for the, in the meantime, they're piloting it within the central.
True.
Yeah. Central districts are known to be criminal hubs.
Yes.
And if you're moving to sub-counties, it means you're leaving other communities vulnerable to criminality. Oh. How will we manage this?
And that's the challenge that police faces. First and foremost, the way you people are merging the stations, there's a lot of panic.
Mm.
Because one, the public has not been told.
Yes.
You know, you did not prepare the public. So people are actually that kind of panic, because the other day we did a story, people are going to report a case, they find the police post closed. Now, ultimately, what this is going to do is, unless police strengthens its intelligence system, we are going to have a sudden surge in criminality. Because I am looking at a situation where we put police at a sub-county level.
Mm.
By the time they respond to an incident that has happened at a village or a parish level, you see, so what now police has a challenge now to ensure that you increase on motorized patrols, to increase on the intelligence gathering, so that we are able to. So it has implications, great implications, especially, as you said, Central is a hub of most criminals actually are within these areas.
That's,
these are
that's true.
Metropolitan areas. Mm. So police has a very big challenge. And my urge is they should not implement the phasing down of police posts in a rush and in a panicky way.
Mm.
Let them engage the population. We should have alternatives. Okay, because you see, you are telling people, okay, we are going to the sub-county, but what alternative are you giving the people?
Yeah.
How do we communicate in case of a criminal incident?
Mm.
That is the challenge that I see.
Absolutely, I find it.
No, actually, like from the metropolitan, we are not implementing the sub-county.
Mm.
Those are going to be at wards. Mm. Those are the parishes.
Mm-hmm.
For example, like Entebbe, where I stay, we are not affected at all. For example, in Argara, where I stay, we had a police station. One, that one is remaining. Katavi, they had one, it is remaining. Subi, they had one, because those are wards. Then sub-counties, we are meaning these outer sub-counties.
Mm.
Then we empower that sub-county with at least 20. With motors, we are starting with the motorcycles, but there are some that will be having vehicles. We have the motorcycles, then we have these all other categories. We have the zero at the sub-county, we have soccer at the sub-county, we have traffic at the sub-county, we have FFU at the sub-county, so that if there is a matter, they can quickly respond. We had these small police posts, where you have just two. They were telling us, it was in Ulisa, a colleague had a leave, he had an issue, remained an OC, and OC was going for an arrest. What happened? The wife saw a gap. She took over. When our bosses were passing, they got a woman at the counter. Who are you? I'm a wife to the OC. Are you a police officer? Nothing. Do you think that police post can help you in case of anything? Having two people, and we're having very many of that type. We are talking, as the Charles put it, people offered. And when someone, when a community, one individual is offered, as police will thought, let us deploy. But we later saw it is not sustainable. Others would have a business with a shop, say, I've given this shop, put police. Sometimes for his own interest, not even for the community. So as the church put it, somehow it was, the process was abused. And we saw, they would even call us. You reach at the post, at night they also close. Psychologically, you think we have a police post, but which essentially is not there. So that's why we are visiting at sub-county, if we empower sub-county, and also revive community police seriously, up to the village level. Village security committees are working, sub-county security committees are working. With that network, plus that one of the other sister forces, I think we can do better.
Let me ask you, Afande, I'm giving you an example of in my home in Mbarara. For example, you have police at Nyakayojo.
Yes.
From Nyakayojo to the village, there's some distance to because that is the sub-county. What are you going to? I feel like the distance is too much for response matters. I'm giving an example. Most villages are far away from sub-counties.
Actually, good enough, you are giving me an area I know very well.
Yes.
Because that's where I come from. We had one, which was, if you know Nyakayojo very well, that boundary between Nyakayojo and Rugando.
Yes.
But they've already informed me that the plan is it is going to be shifted to the sub-county. Nyakayojo, you know where it is
very well. Yes.
If you go to where church is, how many kilometers are they? Around three.
Yeah, they're about.
If you go to Rishenche, where you come from, around two. The only farthest place would be Chitwamba. And Chitwamba, the nearest police is Ruti, where the division sits now.
Wow, there's a distance.
That is a district now, with a vehicle. So it can, the district can respond quicker than even the sub-county. I totally agree that some sub-counties, especially in Nakasek, you find they are a bit wide in the whole sub-county. But if systems are put in place, and then we have the swift people to the sub-county with a proper mindset change, which are working on as political education, proper mindset, I know we can be up to the task.
Yes, Charles.
Maybe the challenge that now you face with, now that you're bringing police back at the sub-county level, is you must bring officers with passion. I'll give you an example. Recently, we had an incident in Buyogere where one of your top officers stays. We reported an incident in Buyogere. And from Buyogere to our place is almost a kilometer.
It took
a short distance. Imagine it took us an hour to get a response from. Now, the challenge was also when you, the challenge that which we must face is that a number of your officers do not serve people well. So you must make sure you work on efficiency. So at the sub-county level, someone will tell you they don't have fuel to respond to an incident.
That's true.
So there are a few things that you need to put in place as you roll out the sub-county level policing, that you must ensure that you give your people enough resources to respond to incidents. I shouldn't be calling and then someone asks me for fuel to respond to a crime. People lose faith in you. And the other thing that we are also not seeing is that, the way I see, I foresee, we are going to have an increase in the population now taking matters into their hands.
Absolutely.
Because people are not there to respond to incidents. So police has a lot. Actually, this phase you are going through, you need to do a lot of engagement with the public, with your own officers. They should be able to respond in time. You must have emergency numbers. You must have patrols moving. You should not, actually, what you are now doing, I find it is a bit unfortunate. you're confining police patrols to keeping big people. I've seen people with patrols parked at their homes, outside their homes, and a station doesn't have a patrol. So you need to try and serve the public. This is what you need now to really come out and push for.
Have you, for example, if I can allude to what he's saying, have you, for example, done some sensitization? As you move, have you told the communities there that this is what is happening and this is what we're putting in place? What have you actually put in place?
Actually, sensitization is on. If I can inform you, right now, Deputy Inspector General of Police is touring the whole of Central and is moving with the quite a number of directors. Mm. I was with the team when we were in Ruel.
Yes.
And we meet the police officers. And because what you are telling us, we've picked it already.
Mm.
We are telling these police officers. Then after, we meet other stakeholders. Him, right now is, yesterday was in Mutiana.
Mm.
Right now they are in Mpiji. We sensitize. A child may be right. When we started implementing, maybe we didn't sensitize the public very well.
Mm.
But that's what we are embarking on. And not that we have crossed all of them.
Mm.
Like in Central Uganda, we haven't. That's why Deputy Inspector General of Police is moving with the PM, informing them. Then find out where are the gaps. Even asking other leaders, other DCs, other political leaders, where are the gaps? What is the problem? How can police help?
Mm-hmm.
Of course, Charles is raising the issue of patrol vehicles. We have, but I cannot say they are enough. I may not go into details, those we guard and those we give, those vehicles. Of course, every VIPP is assessed, and the team said, no, this VIPP needs this particular security, and for this particular time, and there are some who are entitled, and their entitlements are known, and they have a different budget for those vehicles. But police, every year, even others are coming, so that at least we try and we facilitate these people. Why we are concentrating it at the sub-count, even the command structure, at the sub-count, it is going to be a serious command structure. If it is that OC at the sub-count, trying to abuse that, then he's going to be held responsible. We are putting each sub-county a landline, which you can even trace back and find out. You got a call at 2 a.m. Was there any response? What did you do? So that each and every individual is accountable. That's why we want senior people, all departments represented there, so that we don't have any gap as we've been having in these villages where we've been having this police board.
Interestingly, Charles, this model, the sub-county policing model, is premised on the need to enhance police visibility, automation of policing services through advanced technology, consolidation of the available resources and assets at the sub-county. Now, you and I know that police, they're going to be given this, at the sub-county are going to have more power. And you know what that means for our police? Mm. They will probably abuse this power and do unthinkable things and do abominable things. I don't know if they're also doing. Do you think they also need some training of sorts, retooling of sorts?
Yes, and in fact, that is a funders department. That's
exactly.
One thing. You see, just like we work at New Vision.
Yes.
With the police, a funder has a lot of work in taking discipline to ideological, I don't know how to call them ideological training.
Mm.
They should love their jobs first and foremost, because by the time you pick up, you choose to go for a job. Unfortunate bit is that people think whoever has joined police has failed at the lower
elsewhere.
Level. So we must make people love these jobs. One thing I would think at the police leadership level is you must ensure that you enhance the welfare and salaries of your staff. Make them love their jobs, make them accountable. And then you try to establish systems of accountability also. I'll give you an example. If we called an emergency line right now here, the police emergency line, and said we have an incident here and they want someone to respond, how long will it take them to respond?
Mm.
At what point have we created an outreach at the sub-county level to ensure that the number of the OC is known among all people? I'll give you an example that for me, usually I pay a cut as a visit whenever a new OC has been brought to our area, to pick his number. I have all the numbers of the OCs in my phone. But how many of us are willing to go to police stations to get those numbers? Because people think when you go to a police station, you've either committed a crime or... So we must create an outreach. Make police lovable to people. And then make, you know, bring police closer to people. This is what you need to do. Make people love their jobs, bring police closer to people. And that's how we are going to... But that's the easiest way of resolving crime. And then also, the police should have constant engagement with the population.
Right.
Right now in our area, we are trying to push for what they call the Mayumba Kumi concept, where we are trying to get the neighbors to know each other.
Mm.
We are putting up security lights. We are trying to... Because we recently realized that we had an issue. Our big man had his own protection, but for us, we're exposed. So, but we worked with the OC to try and create that, put that structure in place. So at our own level, the 10 or 20 houses, we are trying to fight crime at that level. We have the LOC's number, we have the OC station's number, we have the DPC's number, so we can always call and they know where we stay. So if you can create that kind of system, make officers love their jobs, put numbers for, like, I find if a police officer has wronged me, who do I call?
Yeah,
that's
by
one
that
thing
way.
We should know. If I have reported the case at the sub-county level. So let's create that structure where we can report, where you can also receive complaints quietly, and you do your investigations, effect changes. Don't victimize people who are reporting the police. In a way, by the way, we shall be able to resolve all issues of criminality in our communities.
Mm.
As simple as that.
Afande.
Mm. No, Charles is right. And actually, what we've embarked on, it started, but it has not been as active as UPDF is.
Mm.
Having PCs, that is political commissars,
mm-hmm.
at each and every level.
Mm.
And that is purely their work. We've identified some. Already deployed, we are training, so that they find out what is the problem. If the morale of police officers in this particular area is zero, what is the problem? Why is it that police are working as if they are helping people?
Mm.
And that is going to be the role of political commissars, a department that falls under our directorate.
Mm.
And we are serious, the police leadership is serious on it, and we are serious on that. So that everyone must be up to the task. If you don't want to work, if you think they, of course, welfare has always been a problem, but police and the government has tried to improve on the welfare. But of course, it cannot be done all at a go. But you joined when you know what you're joining and the salary you're going to earn. So if you cannot be comfortable with that, please, instead of putting people's life at stake, just feel free.
Excuse yourself.
Excuse yourself. But we are seriously working on the issue of attitude,
mm-hmm.
working on the issue of morale, then as also handle the welfare. I'm happy, Charles, and it is not their area alone. Surely, why should you be with my number and you don't have the number of the OC of your area? Because he's the near, because when you call me, I'm going to call him.
Absolutely.
But if you had his number, it will be a direct contact.
Mm.
But as I said, we're going to have counter phones. Then what you formed, this is what used to work then. A person would mind about the neighbor's property, neighbor's children, but now others, it is too much to make concern. So if you've created that, well, people have created WhatsApp groups.
Mm.
You find it is an estate.
Mm.
Of 20, 50 homes.
Mm-hmm.
What is wrong having a WhatsApp for that group so that the area police is also in that WhatsApp group?
Mm.
If just is being attacked and he posts,
mm.
then everyone is concerned.
That's right.
Then you put pressure on it so that if they feel, you can even call the center so that they come in. And why we put, make sure that we have every CRO, community policing officer at every sub-county, is to sensitize, inform these people what is their role. Much as we are mandated to provide security, but as civilians, they have also a role to play.
Absolutely.
The first line of security is you.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to work together so that we improve security.
I find I like that you bring out the issue of community policing. and well, neighborhood, we'd rather call it maybe that neighborhood. Where does this merger of to the sub-counties, where does it leave community policing and maybe neighborhood policing?
Community policing, we've been doing our best. But this is the time, that's what we are telling the commissioner in charge community policing, SCP Anatole Mweterwa. This is the time we have to double our effort. Because with this merger, the public must be closer to the police. Because that is going to be the line. How is the LOC system working? How active are they? Then trickle up sub-counties, parish there. How are they? How are we in touch? Do we have, for example, the telephone numbers of all LOC1's chairman in your sub-county, you as OC station? So that if there is a problem in a Karama, I can pick a call and call Chairman LC1. I'm picking this. Or Chairman LC1 Karama can call me. If it is in Richacha, the same. If it is in Rachacha, the same. If it is in Chibingo, the same. So that, but you find an OC doesn't know even this chairman. And there are some people who are trying to, even we got it in Ruel, that the public is also, they don't, I doubt. The public has never been hostile to police. It is you, the individual commander. If you become hostile to them, they'll be hostile to you. Of course, I know you, especially during elections, sometimes you crash here and there, but they also want security. Even if they're opposition, they want security. If you invite them, they will come. Get them there. They always will invite us for functions. Pass a message.
You usually come and eat and go.
And you see, I find that the biggest challenge now that you face, which I see going forward,
right,
is that you need to work on your relationship with the public. I will tell you that I would meet an army officer and confidently, you know, there's a way you meet an army officer and you're so confident that you know you're in safe hands. But there's a way you meet a police officer and you feel so insecure.
You even hide away from them.
So which is, you need to work out on that relationship between the police and the public. If you can engage, if you can constantly do engagements, I have seen in our area now people are pushing for sports, people are pushing for. And then please don't allow officers overstaying in one station. This is also another problem that I'm also, I've been seeing. The other day when we had a suspect, we arrested somewhere, and then the person handling the file had been there for so many years, and he has made it a habit to even ask money for you to help you take the suspect to court. So it's also, I like what your colleague Afande Tom Magam was doing, trying to push some of these officers who have stayed in the station because they become complacent, they become part of that system. But engagements, police needs to do a lot of engagements. You need to get out, engage the population, make them love you. But once the public loves you, we'll not be having incidents of crime.
Actually, what Charles is saying, I'm not hearing it for the first time from him, that you'd rather meet an army officer than a police officer.
Yeah.
I think we need to do research and find out why it is like that. But it's true, we have some overzealous officers. And when you become overzealous, when you're doing police work, somehow you'll create enemies. And we are handling that. But as I said earlier, I don't think police were unpopular, as some people tend to put it. And
compared to?
Compared to them. Well, that one, of course, I know Ame is liked, and but even us, because me, for example, personally, there's no single weekend I have which is free. Functional, or inviting for fun. If we are unpopular, why are they inviting us for this
one? That's a bigger function, but we do want to see. I just want you to, but this is something that you see, because some of you are the officers, the ones that who have not been taken through, the way they behave, the way they engage with the public. That's why you have a role. That's why I'm saying you must try to bridge that gap between the public and police. Make them love you. It's very easy by their funding.
For you, the big ones. We force ourselves on you.
I would want to get seated with you every time.
Yeah.
But now the other small police officer who has his own anger.
Yes.
In fact, a friend was telling me the other day he was driving and he was almost splashing, but he saw the man, like he was carrying a gun and very annoyed. We should make them loved. I need to meet a police officer at a small rank and, you know, like I should love him. So let's create that kind of an atmosphere. And I found the other also thing that I also wanted to raise was police also should implement its programs in the long run. Because you see now we have a challenge that every time, like you see this is a 2019 decision, but it's being rushed right now because we are pushing because of these. Now people are tying it down to the wave of attacks.
Yes.
We should have long-term programs that should be implemented. If a decision has been taken, implement. Mm. Then you're rushing to implement. Then public is having all these misconceptions and no one is coming up to explain what is happening. Then you leave the public. So
in
people
panic.
Lose trust in you. So you need to take time to build trust in people, make people love you as they keep on saying it. Then we will not have issues of crime in this area.
Actually, Charles raised something earlier about overstaying in a particular area. So some officers. Yesterday when we were in, the other day when we were with the DIG in Ruel, they raised the same issue.
Yeah.
Now someone overstays in a post, marries there, opens a bar there. You have in-laws now in an area. How are you going to be efficient? And the DIG was serious on that issue. The policy is there.
Mm-hmm.
But somehow, I think may not have been so keen in implementing, especially those small ones, the one we're talking about,
yes.
The one we are abusing.
On the ground. Yes.
Someone, of course, if someone has opened a bar,
yes.
Someone has married there,
how
do you expect
they are compromised.
They're totally compromised. But usually the standard is two, at least three to 4 years in a particular area.
Okay.
So that you go and serve somewhere else. However good you are, if you are good, go and improve another area.
Mm-hmm.
So that one, DIG picked it, and serious it is going to be implemented. But on relationship, day by day, we try to improve on our relationship with the public, because we cannot do much if we don't have
absolutely,
the public.
Absolutely.
Fandi, maybe
yes.
Just the Kira Police Station, recently, the Kira Division, the main Kira Division, the Boyogero Division, has had constant matches with the Boda Boda, with market vendors, and I see it is doing a lot in public, that building up relationship.
Even in Fort Porter, you went for
so
a similar.
Like now, if we did a lot of, I would imagine that you should have a program every Saturday and Sunday.
Mm.
Police should be doing community, like doing engaging the community in some community
activities.
Yeah. Like, so that you have the previous IGP used to have that thing of running.
Mm.
The OCs at the particular stations should be championing. I mean, that's why people get to know you. You should just say, today I'm going to follow this road. I want people to know, get my number.
Mm.
You knock someone's gate, introduce yourself as the OC, say, this is my number. You also don't have to wait for people to come to you. Get
my
to
natural.
Them. So that is how we will, because most of us fear coming to your place.
Of course. Now, Charles, do you think this new move of merging these police posts, will it solve the issue of criminality?
Two things. One, merging is okay. Me, I have no problem with it. As long as Afande does a few things, puts a few things in place. One,
it's also an economic move.
Creates an outreach.
Mm.
People get to know that if I have a problem, this is where I should go.
Mm-hmm.
And as they merge, they should ensure that they work well with the local councils. They work well with their sister agencies in the area because the ISO has the PISO, the GISO, the whatever.
Mm.
So we must have those teams working together. No one should operate alone. Because when you're fighting a crime, you fight the crime as a community.
Okay.
Let police do the merger, but let them try as much as possible to be open, be transparent, be efficient. Let's have systems put in place to report incidents where an OC, where a police post has failed to act. And then investigation should be carried out independently and action taken.
Mm.
So when I have reported the matter to Afande Kulaiji and something has been done, then I will get the confidence to report next time.
Yes. Mm.
So these are a few things that they should sort out as they push this. Let them not panic. Let them not push things in panic. And I also urge the local leaders in whatever district you are, support the police. They should be supported. But as you support, they also owe us a duty to ensure that they do things in a very transparent and clean way.
Afande, do you really think that move really will reduce criminality in our communities?
No, definitely it will. As Charles put it.
Maybe over time.
Me, I'm convinced there are some of these posts that were not helping us much.
Okay. Did you start with those ones or you just went blanket?
Actually, we started depending on how many do you have at the post, how far is it from the sub-county, then what is the population in that area.
Mm.
That's how we are phasing them out.
Okay.
Then perhaps the location. You cannot have a police post in the middle of the shop. It is surrounded by shops. Even Obusika itself. You saw the location of that Obusika.
Mm.
So we are doing that assessment. Then where we think it is needed, but where it is located is not fit, then which alternative do you have? I know it is going to reduce, as Charles put it, let us empower the sub-counties, both in terms of manpower, in terms of logistics, and of course, the attitude you talked about.
Let me paint a picture of a hard-to-reach area, for example. Which example do I give? There are very many.
A beam.
Imagine a beam. Now, you have to, you have a police post at the sub-county. Imagine there's a crime somewhere deep in the village and there has several kilometers to reach there. What happens? Have you thought about that?
By those, some of those sub-counties, apart from those with some big trading centers, many some were having just at the sub-county.
Mm-hmm.
Go to Weju, you have at Bihanga, you have at Marindi, you have at Bede. Those have been at the sub-county, and it has been operating.
Mm.
The only issue is where you have these small trading centers mushrooming up, and you want that services,
yes.
Then is how the mobility in that particular area. But the abim you are talking about, those sub-counties are covered and they are going to be
obviously
we are going to add manpower.
Obviously, funded. That is what you'd say. But talking about manpower, Charles, we know that police has always had issues with manpower, human resources, but also the fuel we're talking about, vehicles to ease movement. There's, if you need, if something has happened in your area, you have to go to police and they'll ask you for transport, to put in fuel, money for the dogs, all those things.
Yes.
Are we really at the point where we will be able, the police will be able to really do its job without interfering, without actually asking me for, some fuel?
I believe with the discipline is also very key, because you see, police has its budget. They usually budget for fuel, they budget for, like dogs, but they are free of charge. No one is supposed to ask you for money.
Ah, they charge because people for dogs, sniper dogs.
I spoke to Afande Muguma, I think they have really tried to give out dogs.
Mm-hmm.
The issue is discipline. As long as we put discipline in place, budgets, plans are done well, I don't think we should be having that problem of lack of fuel. But it's because of, I think sometimes also the amount of money they get from Minister of Finance maybe may not be enough for them. But they should appeal for more funds. Because as a matter of fact, criminality in an area, scares away people and people live in panic.
Yeah.
I am sure that the police management, if they ask the government to give them more funds for a specific duty, the funds will be available. So with the funds being available and discipline, I think all these things will be sorted out. I don't see why I should come to a police. And but there are some communities that are so good that they can even offer to fuel, to establish a monthly fee for
that's
a police
true.
Post.
That's true.
But we should not tie down this to you have a case, pay me, give me fuel. People should love their jobs. Once they love their jobs, then so police needs to put in place that zero tolerance to corruption. Those are key things that should be running around police stations.
I feel like with police we continuously say avoid corrupt officers, and it's a song that has no end. And with this new move, I think you need to put up some really really strict measures.
Like Afande Kulaiji, the other day the IGP said you should not, photocopying machines at police stations should not be there. But you find police officers owning. You see, they're at level of, that small level of, because of complacency.
Yeah.
People have been there because the directive has been issued, but no one is following.
And also limited inspection, perhaps.
Yes. So we should have constant inspections, and because you have suspects who have stayed in a police post, have been to a police post, suspect has been there for 4 days, the file is not moving. The file has not even been reported to the station. He's at a police post. Someone is micromanaging his own issues at the police post. So. So there are issues that inspection should be constant. As you put the CLOs, please put also police inspectors at those different substations. And accountability should be there. Then we'll have...
No, Charles, as he put it, is mainly on the discipline. Much as the resources, however, even if the resources may not be enough, but the issue of the discipline it takes the lead. It you find it is an individual's interest, and we have to get money.
Mm-hmm.
But not that really all the time resources are not enough. Well, resources have never been enough. But at least if you're the OC station, something is lacking. You have a DPC. If the DPC lacks fuel, he has his RPC. Then the RPC communicates to the headquarters.
Mm.
FTO usually puts operational fuel. That week, operations may have been busy, you may have been busy, and used more fuel than what you allocated.
Mm.
You communicate. They will definitely, I have been in command. I was another piece in your area.
Mm-hmm.
There's some days when operations would be quite many in Barara. You tell headquarters, the fuel you gave me, I've finished it in 15 days. They will send you fuel. So these officers shouldn't use that there's no enough resources and they do whatever they want. Print now these police forms. We've got our own printer now at Namanve. To print these forms, if it is a form for bond, a station should have enough forms. If it is a form for medical form, should be having enough forms, but not saying, give me 2,000, I photocopy for you a police bond. And these officers, quite many, have been charged. Others have been dismissed because of that unprofessionalism. The region has an inspection team headed by the deputy RPC to go down and see what these people are doing.
Right.
Headquarters has the same team to counter what the region is doing. Then we also have a RAT squad attached to operations to try and fight that. And I'm telling you, that's what I was telling officers in Ruel, with this margin, because we are being tested by the public, so we cannot allow people who've put at the sub county to let us down. And it is business as usual, it won't.
I'm worried about that because, but the issue of human resource, do you have enough, or are you going to do some recruitment, or are we going to see some gaps in there as well?
Of course, steel manpower is like other resources. We don't have enough manpower, but at least we always recruit. This is now we are done with the interviews.
Yes.
There's a team going to Kabarde very soon. So that we always, because the turnover also is there.
Mm.
Others are dying, others are deserting, others are doing, so that at least if there's the funds are not enough to recruit too many, usually finance gives us a chance to fill the gaps of those that have either died or deserted. And you find at least we always feel, but given the ratio, we are still below to the standard ratio of 1 per 500. But at least we are getting there.
But even the ones you are recruiting, you should make them know that they are not there because they are rejects in society.
Mm.
You know, you need to make them. I talked about this earlier. Make them feel that they are there because they are supposed to serve. As once that spirit of service comes into them, maybe we'll get a new changed force, because now this is a new team that is coming into office. They already a team that is there that is a bit messed up, I find it's hard to change them right now.
Mm.
But the new team we are pushing up should be at least reoriented to love the force, to love their service. And
actually, that has been a perception even to the public. Mm. There's a lady who asked me if I've ever gotten a job or I'm still with police.
Mm.
So thinking that being in police is not,
it's a not
job. Yeah. So she was wondering, have you ever gotten a job or you're still with the police?
Oh.
So even some officers may think they failed to get jobs even in vision where. So let me resort to that, which is not the case.
Mm.
Police is among able and noble institutions one would feel to work for.
Mm.
So to be there and you think, let me just join police, and you come with that mentality.
Mm.
I don't think you can survive with us for some time.
Charles, just going back a little bit,
we
started off saying that these mergers have actually caused some panic in our communities. Now, I don't know if police has gotten wind of this and what they're doing about it, but what would you rather they do? We already talked about sensitization.
Yeah.
But what What more can they do to avert this panic?
I saw the biggest issues came from Mitiana, I think, and Muvende. Well, a number of MPs actually came up and spoke about
it. Yes, yes.
So I have a feeling that police needed to go back on the ground and then do an explanation to the leaders with a justification. You need to indicate that, okay, in this sub-county we had 10 police posts, but this is the number of population. Now, if you bring it to the sub-county level, this is what we are going to do. We are going to create in place a team of, say, two SOCOs, 10 CIDs. Then you tell them the services they would get by you going to the sub-county. And then also give them the assurance that you'll be able to respond to their issues even when the post has been removed. So I think you didn't engage, I think Afande Kulaje, you didn't engage an MP called Lumu, who complained.
Mm.
So you need to personally engage them because they made it a campaign for almost a week. So engagement, going back there and explaining to people would actually help resolve most of these issues. So I feel you still need to go back and engage.
Even in Busika,
they just woke up after the attack, you closed this police post station. Now you imagine I've walked to come and report a case. I find there's no. So you need to engage using those local media houses, tell them this police station is moving here. Use the LOC structure in the areas, explain to them. I am sure they will also explain back to their people. And of course, some of these cases come from the LOC to police.
Mm.
So engagement, again, is what you need to do.
Mm.
Yeah.
No, it's true, and I think, as I said, that's why Deputy Inspector General of the Police and his team in those regions trying to explain, meet the leaders, and tell them the need and how best we are going to handle it. And of course, sensitization is going to be continuous.
Mm.
If IGP leaves, another team goes, then we have these teams at the region, have teams at the district, so that you sensitize, remove that fear. Not that we are running away as they are trying to portray.
And also maybe my prayer for the future is that I come from the border area. From some of us have Butororo. Now I like following what happens in other countries. In Kenya, for instance, recently we had a recruitment of a new IGP, equivalent of an IGP, and then subsequent officers were also recruited. But some of you officers who are holding those positions up there, you should have a bit an accountable way of seeing you guys go through these ranks. I saw the head of DCI in Kenya giving out his number publicly.
Mm.
And that, you know, because you see there are cases I may have to report to Afande Magambo. I can't access him.
Yeah.
So we need to have also, police officers should also be as transparent as possible. And Afande, from you, Afande, I could expect you even to start, since you are at the, up there, Afande, let's be open. That if I have an issue, I should be able to reach out and my issues are resolved. Because not everybody will just call you for fun. There are people who really have issues.
Yeah,
but I have seen people who come to the reception at New Vision here with the really serious issues.
True.
And sometimes we don't know where to start from. So sometimes we opt to write these things in the media. Yet, if you helped a person resolve his issue, so we need also, as we do all these things, I find transparency is key. How do I reach Afande Kulaije? Afande, I don't think even, maybe your number is restricted to a few of your friends. Yet you serve the public. So let's try to get out our numbers outside. Recently you had Mango Lines. Now I think they are all off. Let's share out our numbers. And when they call you, please respond. This is how we'll sort out.
And that is how we fix the relationship with the public.
And we will love you more.
And I don't see any problem giving your number to a public officer.
Yes.
Because indeed, as much as I said, it's better start with your OC. But also having a number up to IGP, there's no problem. And I don't see there's any harm. And even when you call 99 or command center, you say, I want the telephone number of director CID, you'll get it.
They will ask you why.
Yeah, I find now that's what for you, they will get it because it's a Afande Kulaije calling.
Uh-huh.
But for me,
you want us straight from here?
If I called, they'll be like, who are you? Yes. What business do you want with him? Do you have all those things?
Off air, we are going to try.
Right.
No, but he's right. We need
his
number. And then we'll also even give it right from here.
Absolutely. No before arm. You give that number. Mm. As police is merging, there are key aspects of the model that involve establishment of at least one police station per sub-county, deployment of not less than 20 personnel, deployment of motorcycle squads, installation of counter phones that are popularized among residents, dedicated counter response teams, critical facilities, modern lockup facilities, better accommodation and medical services. Now, you probably, as I finish this sentence, I'm laughing or smiling. Charles, you and I know that this is all idealistic. This is all very idealistic. I don't know if we'll pull this off.
Recently, I was in Mbale, but I think that's the challenge you have. Recently, I was in Mbale and I saw police actually has very good, they are trying to put up accommodation after I think MPs went there and they. But now they have not come up to show those photos. So people still have those old pictures. So communication also is key.
Yes.
Now, I wouldn't want to take, because now I will be running an advert for police. Of course, I have a duty to communicate because now police has a new house. But you should get out more and engage. Now, this all can be achieved because, one, all these issues are raised there have a budget. They are budgeted for, they have been planned.
That's true.
Police has a director of planning that does all these things. I think it was formally headed by Afando Chom. Those funds are available. The issue is implementing. That's where the challenge comes from. Along the way, I don't know where, because now if you go to old camp, but then you need to go to those police barracks. Sometimes you would understand why a police constable reacts the way he reacts.
Absolutely.
Because where they sleep, you know, you have sewer, you have everything. So that alone, if the man wakes up in the morning and carries his gun, he has all that anger on him. So I find, I'm sure, issues of good accommodation. This will bring back confidence also in the police officer carrying a gun to serve. Because there's no way you expect me to carry a gun and I'm staying in a place where sewer, the house is leaking. You have to cross. One time I slept in a barracks in Soroti. I had to cross three beds to go to my other, where I was sharing with a colleague. So you would imagine that situation. Those people are traumatized by the, moving, but I find for you up there. We are okay.
Yeah, he lives in Entebbe.
But these police officers are traumatized. So when do you empower the local? We also need to empower the local police officer at the bottom level. Then that will inspire us. Because if I go and I get good service, I will come back and report another case.
That's
but when
true.
I go and I get a bitter man who has not had breakfast, who slept yesterday, the house was leaking on him. So let's support. That is a very good idea. If we
very,
do that,
very good.
We'll have changes.
Okay, that's why I had to ask you. Why are you laughing? Among the things you read, which one cannot be achieved?
Accommodation, medical bills, and then the counter response. We know how you put. What is your problem? Okay, and then move on to something else.
And I find that is the biggest challenge you face. Counter.
Counter
you meet officers at the counter. It's like she has not eaten for the last 3 days. She has all the anger. Actually, you can move to Jinja Road Police Station or CPS. The people you meet at the counter, you've come to our reception at New Vision. You've seen the lady there.
We pay attention.
Very receptive. She will ask you, what do you want? How may I help you? If we can bring that culture back into police, do you want to see the OC station? Do you have a problem? And don't let her not try to solve your problem, because some problems are private. She directs you to the right person. And those issues are resolved. But they just bark at you like your dog. I've not come back to the police. I'll keep on hiding a crime in my area. I'll resort to mob justice to resolve my issue.
That's
so
true.
Let's have that.
Actually, what she read, what I can say that it is not in each and every subcountries we are talking about, is the accommodation.
Yes.
And as Charles put it, the management has really embarked on the issue of accommodation.
Okay.
Soon we are calling it Naguru, because we shall be reaching those flats. Very beautiful. They are not in many places here in Kampala.
They are probably for the big shots. Like,
by the way, from the rank of ASP and above, you're not supposed to stay in the barracks.
Oh.
Yeah. Unless you are the DPC or OC station. We want to cater for inspectors, the two stars and below. We want to make these boys and girls very comfortable.
Yes.
And the plan is there, quite many, but the issue is they started mainly with where there was nothing, basically.
Anyway.
It's already had a station.
I want us to wind up on this.
To improve,
we're running out
but
of time.
But at least we've tried. Then the rest, counter, motorists, cycles, all those ones are there, and you will not see any gap.
I think you need to take them for
customer care, customer care,
training.
We're even now training.
Yes.
Pure on customer care. I agree with you, the two of you. Our customer care, you reach in some places, it is really lacking. But we are working on it, and we are training these people on customer
Others,
care.
You come to report your problems, like men that you have been beaten by your wife. Yeah. They simply sit down and laugh.
Laugh at you. And yes, they are being beaten.
Exactly. Yeah. So anyway, Afande, I need you to give us your number as we conclude. Maybe your number or the numbers that, you know, are very critical. You promised. So here you are.
The numbers, we are going to make sure that all the CLOs publish these numbers, and even though when they come to talk shows, they give all these numbers. You should be having all the numbers of the commanders in Kampala. But for today, let me give mine. I'm on 0772-366-222. 0702-366-222. I've even insisted on giving my personal, so that even if I'm not in this office, I'm in and I'm taking the other office, you can still access me so long as I'm still in the police.
Perfect.
Even if I've left the police, I can
perfect still example. Perfect example. Thank you very much, Afande Kulaije. Thank you very much, Charles, for your time. And those of you who've been watching, police is merging, is bringing, well, they are taking it to the sub-county. I wanted to say bring it closer, but there's a distance. But they're saying it is going to improve services in regard to policing. So do be aware and be on the lookout, but also get the most important police numbers that you might need in case there's a problem. So we're taking a break. When we return, Rush Talk comes back. And today we are looking at some very interesting gentleman, a musician, who turns all sorts of songs into Luganda songs. I don't know how he does that. The translation, very interesting. So stick around. Miles comes back with that and so much more.